think you have to do that on... in settings.
Do I? Okay.
I think so.
Yep.
Because it's...
I mean, that's just so... Yeah. That's just so... That's just so in case you ever post on the chat log, people will know who's typing. But, anyway, we are now live for week 25 of our Rise of the Runelords campaign. And I'm going to make sure something here. Yeah, we're good.
Devilish Swedish fish.
That. Save. Save. Okay.
There we go.
We last left our heroes off on the top of the ramparts of Fort Raddick, where they got the NPC group going one way and they're going another, so the party was split, but not entirely really. Badly.
didn't split the party. Let's keep that in mind.
We don't have to keep our eye on the road.
Because there is no road. Just a kleptomaniac pseudo-dragon and a wizard who, well, she's just... Leary's just Leary. She killed people just to get into Pathfinder Society. I'm sure she's not above swiping things from everyone else's pockets.
Point.
Different time. Like in college, when we made out for 3 hours while everyone watched. Molly's a hell of a drug. Let me just put that out. Are we recording?
Yes.
All right. Remember, kids, Molly is a hell of a drug.
And you should eat it, not smoke it. Seriously, that's what my mom said. When I talked to her about the discussion we had.
Wow.
She was like, now, you're not going to smoke it, right? Right. You're going to eat it.
When we go to Colorado.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was like, wow, okay. Usually I'm the one surprising her with random things that...
Now, I don't mean to be critical, but she does know what Molly is. Like, that's not the straight name for marijuana. Molly's like an actual, it's like ecstasy, like super powered.
That's on me.
Okay.
This is how much of a drug addict I am. Okay. I don't even know what I'm talking about.
So, yeah, you guys are on top of the ramparts. So far, nothing else.
Where's the rocket's red glare?
Up your ass.
I can dig it.
So, you guys are on top of the fort.
So that's why you don't have a girlfriend.
Because I have red rockets in my ass.
There's a comedian whose name I'm completely blanking on, but it's like he's half Korean, or like half Vietnamese, half Irish or something. And he did a thing where the next time you're making love to your woman, put fireworks all around the bed, start blowing candles just as you orgasm, and look down at her like, I'm celebrating you.
Wouldn't that be dangerous?
Possibly. But imagine how awesome it would be.
Now, scented candles, Roman candles, they essentially do the same thing.
Point.
What do you all do now that you're on top of the place?
I thought you were going to say, what do you all do when you have sex? Oh, boy.
This is a little personal, John.
Well, I'm assuming we already went through the tower down in this way direction, right?
Yeah, you guys went from there to where you are now.
All right. So I'm assuming that we should go north, or we should backtrack to the other tower that was along the south.
Yeah, it's all just black to me.
You got to go down. You got to go down and to the right. In fact, fact, you should be seeing
it. Well,
I mean,
she's seeing it, it's just that we can't really see what.
It's all black.
Oh, because you guys are on just a catwalk.
Yeah.
You're not inside the fort, you're still outside, just on top of a wall. Put the lotion in the basket.
You fuck me. I fuck me hard.
Red rock to the butt. Anyways, so there's the tower to our immediate south, and then there's the one off westerly. Yeah, off westerly ways that's being blocked right now. And then there's one to our north.
See?
At least as far as I can remember.
So let's go in one.
I like the way she thinks.
I'm wondering which tower you guys would prefer to check out. If we should backtrack and make sure we've got no one following us, or if we should head forward.
Well, like the Black Arrows told you, the ogres wouldn't really be able to climb up the ladders into these towers, so you're relatively safe where you are.
So we could just explore at our own leisure?
Well, only these two walkways and three towers, but eventually you'll have to go down the ladder of one of them.
No, we don't. We can stay up here forever.
And they're all just sitting outside, where are those guys?
Hey, I'm still going through my inventory. A lot of shit here.
I'm busy raising a gold chocobo.
I'm running back and forth across the wall to get experience before the boss fight.
Meteors falling across... Falling down the world? I still need to get that Knights of the Round material, goddammit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure it will take just as long to reach the ground.
I'm sneaking here. Put the rubber band on the controller.
Yeah.
Walk away. Come back. Your sneak's at like 100.
The thing is to do that, though, you have to, like, wake up at, like, 9 in the morning, and you shouldn't expect to play until, like, 7 at night.
True.
No real easy way to do that in Skyrim? Learn the dragon call that throws your voice.
Mm-hmm.
Go into a dungeon. Wait until you know that there's a group of undead or whatever down a hallway. Throw your voice with all three words. It'll get their attention and have them walking around. You'll see the eyeball light up noticing you. But since they're never coming in your direction, you'll keep gaining stealth, but they'll eventually drop notice and just do it over again. All you have to do is just sit there and you'll just keep racking up stealth points.
So let's check out the one to the north.
Yes.
Yep. Alright.
Marching order?
Let's see.
Please don't have Lucy in front.
No, I'm either Menendez or Kronk in the front.
And Menendez.
Kronk, Menendez, Stanton will be in the middle, followed up by
Lucy. And Theodora.
As rear guard. Alright.
Excuse me. Yes.
Do it to it, Lars.
Ooh, excuse me.
So you're going up to that northern tower.
Yep.
Let me grab the line, dammit. There we go.
I've got one for you to grab. Get it like a fishing line.
So yeah, the door to that tower is unlocked, so you're able to go right on in, and it's just another trap door that leads down a ladder into the fort interior.
Because your penis is fish?
What?
He made a comment that was sexual. He made a comment to make it not sexual, and I made a comment to make it sexual again. Because...
That's what she said?
Yeah.
Hey, can you see your character?
Oh, I have to move them?
Yeah.
I mean...
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to.
So, what's the ground, what's like the, what do we see at the base in the courtyard? Are we not allowed to look over the ramp?
When you look over, you see it just as you left it with the burnt up.
No, I mean on the inside.
Oh, on the inside? The inside of the fort. The inside of the ramparts between it and the fort building is all empty, aside from discarded dead bodies.
Okay.
Loot! I loot them!
There's nothing of value on them whatsoever.
Curses!
Alright, so
it looks like the ogres were using that those small interior spots just for body dumping.
So we're gonna go down the troll. We're gonna go down the boys' hole.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
In the troll. All
right.
All right. I shall start moving you one at a time. Everybody is going to go to the immediate left side of the screen.
I have zoomed out completely so I can see what.
Starting with
Crumb. Yeah, I'm that.
I'm also going to do this real quick. Get rid of this door. So, anyways.
10 is a lot bigger than your 10.
Your what?
10%.
Stamp.
Oh, whatever.
Leery.
Technical.
Lucy.
Doohickory.
And Theodore. Alright. So now you're all in a library. With a long table with benches to either side, sitting in this room opposite of a bookshelf filled with dozens of books, most of which have been torn from the shelves, mangled, and then messily stuffed back into place. You also have... Where is that board?
It's not a very big library, is it?
Probably not. You also got a door right down here. And...
Is that the only way out of the room?
Yes.
Is it a fiction library? Like science fiction and adventure books? Or is it... Oh, it's one of those boring scholarly libraries, isn't it?
Yes.
That's
exactly what it is.
God damn it. Alright.
The door is shut. It doesn't appear to be locked. And there are, at least in this room, no torches lit. So... You're all relying on your own devices for light.
Okay, remember Menides has his floating iron stone that's giving light, so he needs 20 feet of light.
Oh yeah, I already got him set, so
okay.
He's already giving off light.
Disable device. Perception? What am I rolling? I'm looking for traps.
You're looking for perception.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, I don't see much. 2 + 5, 7.
As far as Theodore is concerned, there's nothing.
It's dark! Why can't I see anything?
Don't you have dark vision?
She has low light vision. Within the light radius of
she
this
has light.
Stone, she's able to see twice as far.
Like the box.
That'll work.
Over. Okay.
Well, I mean, I'm like.
My abs.
Like a reach over.
Which are not flat at all.
Okay. Twenty-two perception, checking the door for.
The door is completely clean.
Is it unlocked?
Yes, it is.
Menides, the 27th, opens the door.
So, you open the door to a blood-stained hallway where it pretty much looks and smells as though body after body after body were drugged through here.
Can I change the token name?
Yeah, if you double-click it, I think.
Settings.
Or that, too.
You know, the last thing you do when you die is you crack your pants.
Why, yes. Yes, you do.
I just saw the I saw the South Park episode today.
The Walmart one.
The Walmart one.
I have to give it its full name.
Okay, so right now, since Menendez is still standing in the door frame, he can always
Menendez
see
the 27th.
Menendez the 27th. You're going to make me do that the whole time, aren't you?
No.
Okay. Standing in... Okay. So now, Menendez the 27th, there is a stairway that leads down right in front of him. Door here. Door there. And a pair of double doors there. And another pair of double doors just south of him. And also doors along the side of the corridor.
It does goes north.
To that door?
Yep. 28 perception.
That door is also clean.
Opens it up.
Do you want to wait until the party kind of gathers forth and we have a formation?
Well, it be assumed that they're coming out.
Alright. That door has a stairway that leads up, plus a storeroom full of crates and barrels and stacks of firewood, smashed apart and heaped in tangled piles along the corner of this room.
Loot it! Now,
this flight of stairs lead down, actually. The stairs that were in front of you before are the ones that lead up.
Alright. I think Theodore right now is on top of Menendez. Which is kinky.
Theodore is looting everything.
There's mostly spoiled food in there.
Oh. Okay.
In firewood.
Watch. Wanna check the door next to Stanton now? Alright. Perception check on traps.
You're also seeing, from the right side, an ogre. What looks to be his right half of his face looking like it had been sliced off and repaired. Other than that, he would have looked like an actual symmetrically handsome ogre, which is extremely rare, so until half of his face got sliced off and then repaired. He's still going away, messing with one of the other dead bodies, not noticing the door had been opened at all.
Well,
surprise. What the hell am I thinking? I shouldn't name myself here. I like maybe watch the show twice about my childhood.
Okay.
Tenchi.
Tenchi Muyo?
Yeah.
Then I could be Ryooki?
Oh god. No.
Wait, we really want to go down that route?
It's going to
the spaceship.
Oh yeah, sure.
Yeah.
And this is going to what?
Or wash you.
A man's colon to paint the wall.
Going to use cast spark on body part.
Alright. Does he have to roll anything against it or
spark?
That is how you spell Calrissian, right?
What?
He was obviously the greatest character of all of Star Wars. Only in two movies.
Instantaneous fortitude negates.
But also.
Unattended flammable object can't fire. This works as if you're using. Okay. So, it just catches fire.
Yep.
So when it catches fire in his hand, he immediately drops it and backs away like, ah! No fire bad!
Oh, goody.
And then he walks over and proceeds to stomp it out, sending crud everywhere.
It's like the flaming bag of poo trick?
Yes, exactly.
So, is this gray thing a table here?
Yeah.
Okay. Menendez is going to move in, jump on the table, and attack.
Are you going to move in stealthily, or just once right away?
Oh, do we have a surprise round, or...
Yeah.
We used said round. Surprise round? Okay. Menendez is going to just charge right in. He can. Modifiers are enough. He can jump up on the table without needing that.
I'm just moving.
And so.
Hurry up so I can actually see what's going on. Because. Yeah.
Yeah, I have no idea what's going on. I can't see.
Does a 26 hit?
A 26 will hit his flat foot.
Okay. So. Oh!
Oh, you can't see just because he went in and he's the only one with light.
14 damage.
Alrighty then. So when Menendez moves in and attacks him, he stumbles a bit and spins around looking right at you. He's like, oh! More playthings! I'll sprawl you against the wall!
Oh, fresh meat.
Yes, fresh meat.
And all I keep thinking about is Roxy. The difference between the this ogre and Roxy is that Roxy is a hot girl, and this ogre is an ogre.
Yeah. Yeah. It's almost like that's a...
Roll initiative.
It's just, the social implications for this is, you know, you walk into a room with an ogre doing artistic things with intestines, and you're like, ooh, kill it. But if it was a hot girl instead...
I'd still kill it.
Would you?
Yeah.
Would you get experience and loot for it?
Points. Point.
Alright, so Menendez and Kronk.
Menendez is 21, like Kronk is 15.
Shades of Grey. You know, if it was... The only reason it's considered erotica is because the guy's a billionaire. If it were set in a trailer park and he looked like a crackhead, it would...
Yeah.
It would take a completely different spin.
Oh, yeah.
Leary and Stanton.
Point.
Alright.
Now, what's your initiative roll?
Initiative.
Stanton's is 20. Leary's is not. Leary's is 6.
Lucy and
10.
Lucy. 10 for Lucy.
Yeah.
Or like, if Loki didn't look like Loki, if he looked like Cthulian octopus head from beyond space and time.
With the tentacles or without?
It doesn't matter.
Menendez, you're at the top of the initiative order.
Alright.
Tentacles are awesome.
Okay, without tentacles.
Okay.
Then it wouldn't be charming or endearing, all his playing around with humanity. It'd be horrifying and disgusting.
True. But the tentacles, they make all the difference.
No.
Menendez will...
So much wrong.
Attack. Let's see. Is...
Lucky. Lucky
is
hold,
he's not holding anything metal or metallic, right?
No.
Okay.
See, like Captain America could look like Rondo Hat.
And it does will attack.
I don't know who that is.
yeah, that's going to hit. 33 hit.
Yeah.
And it's a crit.
Oh, awesome.
Nice.
So...
Rondo Hatton is not an attractive man, okay? He was called Hollywood's monster without makeup for a reason.
Maybe I'm just into monsters.
Stanton.
Alright. I really don't want
to... Maybe we should mention that to her husband next time we go to her house.
Mention what I kind of miss.
That I'm into monsters.
Okay.
Alright.
I mean, he's not that bad looking. Come on.
No. He's... my baby.
All right. Here's a monster. Y'all heard it. Y'all heard it, right?
Here's hoping Alex doesn't hear any of this. Or listen to
this. There are a minimum of 9 people who now know.
Yeah.
Points.
I mean... Who knows? One day this may be heard by literally dozens of people.
So, what is Stanton doing?
He's going to channel the crap out of negative energy.
I guess I can't really say that he doesn't look like a monster if I'm into monsters. Right?
Are we still on this?
Because I'd still find him attractive.
He got a 15 on his will.
That's not high enough. 4.
Okay, I'm done.
6. Alright. 7 plus 9, 16.
He's still kicking.
How much damage did you cause in the first attack?
Like 22 or something?
Let's see, I did 27 plus whatever the first hit was, which was 14.
Okay.
So, I did 41 damage.
Crunk!
So, I have a question.
Yes.
Is there anyone within a 30-foot radius that would have also been hit by that blast?
By which blast is that?
By the channel negative energy.
Players, no.
Let me check real quick.
Are we using video game rules for if they're hurt, they immediately know what it came from?
Shit. Oh, shit.
I'll go ahead and say that no, there was no one within a 30-foot radius.
That's our word, and we're sticking to it.
And plus, when you're hitting this guy, he's making a lot of noises, yet you don't hear any sound of people coming to assist.
I'm unable to move Krunk.
Hang on.
It's because he's Krunk.
Did he freeze?
Get it, like, Krunk. Okay.
Oh, I get it.
Controlled by Minutus 20. You should be able to.
Maybe it's me.
He may have given control to Menendez the 57th. Or just Menendez.
I think it's me.
Uh-oh.
His Internet Explorer is coming up.
That's not good.
Okay. Come on. What's going on?
Oh, are you using Internet Explorer? Not Chrome?
Yes.
Or Firefox?
I am.
Oh, yeah. That'll do it.
It's my wife's.
You hear that, people? He blames his wife for everything.
It's my wife's computer, and she, rather than tell me that there was stuff going on with Firefox, she just stopped using it and started using Internet Explorer. If I try to open Firefox on this computer, it will crash. And I just haven't taken care of it yet.
Okay.
So Krunk moves in, and he will attack.
Get Krunk as soon as possible.
Yeah, I ended up
Something other than Internet Explorer.
I ended up switching from Firefox to Chrome, too.
I still like Firefox.
Alright, so... Krunk...
Smash?
No, Krunk Smash, he's not raging.
Okay.
15.
And Star Trek is ready.
15 is a no.
Now you're gonna be thinking about it.
Lucy and Theo.
Mine?
Yep.
Okay, so no one is coming up on our asses.
I mean...
So, Theo rushes in. How many spaces do I have? Is that an issue?
I think Theodora, when she's flying, gets like 60 feet of movement.
Yeah, movement is never going to be a problem for her.
Okay. So she...
The one thing is, she wouldn't be able to get in that square.
Okay.
She would have to be, like, there.
Can she still reach it?
Yeah, because the ogre is taking up that 4x4 square that the character token sits on, so she will be able to hit it.
Okay. So, she does her thing.
And the ogre is still not armed, hence why he hasn't taken any attack opportunities.
14.
Wait, we're fighting an ogre without arms? This should be easy.
Wait, pal. She only rolled a 14?
Yeah.
That's not going to work.
Okay. So Lucy... steps up. That be line of sight there?
No, because she's got the wall and the door frame. She would have to be in that spot.
Okay. actually going to step in here and do guidance.
Alright. Guidance!
On Kronk.
On
so Kronk. I'm touching his back.
I don't know what the hell Karn is about.
Sure, you're touching his back.
Kronk is happy.
She gives Kronk a little pinch on the butt. Good luck, honey.
All right.
Kronk like being touched in swimsuit spaces.
All right, Ogre's turn. Picking up an item is a minor or standard?
It's a standard action.
Okay.
Does it provoke an attack of opportunity?
It does.
It does provoke an attack of opportunity. There's a space surrounded by three people.
Yep. Well, yeah. But he's an ogre, so he's going to reach out to the table and grab his ogre hook. So that's Theodora, Menendez, and Kronk to make attacks opportunities against him.
18.
18 is in the 5 or less range, so she gets to roll her bite damage.
For 21.
21 hits on the die.
8.
8 points.
She's not on his arm.
Menendez does 14 damage.
Substance. I mean, you're not supposed to be using it, but at the same time, people have a problem with it, so...
I feel like I should be paying attention to y'all's conversation more, because I keep coming in and just hearing random things.
Yeah.
So the drug use is getting, like, it's escalating to more serious drugs every time I tune in.
So we're debating whether or not it's politically correct to be making heroin jokes. And have them be recorded and put online.
Yeah. So he's got his ogre hook in hand now. He's beating his chest. He's like, come on! Meet in your brains! And, Lyra.
I thought it was an ogre, not a zombie.
Ogres like to eat people.
Lyra has line of sight from the doorway there?
Yep.
Alright. The spell. It's a really good spell. She is going to make use of a pencil that I don't know where it went, but fuck it, because there's replacements. Get a still scorching ray on that guy. As if there's anyone else to target.
Yeah. She has to make a ranged touch, right?
Yes, which is base attack plus dick. So that's plus
dick?
You know what? Sure.
Touch is only a 10, so show it.
Okay. She gets two rays, so I think she has to roll for the second one. That's a 19, so that's better.
19 on the die or altogether?
19 on the die.
Okay, so yeah, okay.
It deals like 4d6 each ray?
Yep. 4d6 of fire damage.
Right. Can I borrow your giant block of d6s? Thank you, sir. You're a scholar and a gentleman. At least you try to, when you're not blaming everything on we have that recorded.
Well, here's hoping that your wife doesn't listen to this, and neither does her husband.
He doesn't.
My wife couldn't care less. This is my hobby, and that's mine. Don't try to involve her.
That's a lot of sixes. Actually, only two. Let's see. So that's 12, 14, 17, 20, 35 points of damage.
He is not only engulfed in flames, but he collapses to the ground and dies an agonizing death of being burned alive. Because she just wiped him down to negative 27 hit points.
Da 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 da.
He is dead.
I loot the body.
Plus one hide armor, plus one ogre hook, and.
But it's all for a large creature.
Yeah. That's all she gets. The man on the operating table, all done up artsy-like. You end up seeing that there is a necklace sitting around him. That is the symbol of a bow and arrow. If you want, you can make a knowledge religion check on that if you want.
Well, it was a plus one hide armor for large creature and a plus one
ogre hook.
Presumably for a large creature.
Okay. The sun is down, it should not be hot anymore. It needs to be cooler.
Yeah.
RAC went out yesterday. That was fun.
Ooh.
Better now than in the middle of the summer.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Yeah.
Now it's...
22-year-olds and a month-old baby, and we had no hair. It was great. Three screaming children. Yeah.
That's a 21 on religion check.
You recognize that is the symbol of Aristil.
Aristil.
Yeah. An older deity that is of lawful good and is known for farming, hunting, trade, and family. Teaches followers to embrace traditional and simpler ways of life, free from constraints of modern society, a trait that often finds disagreements with more progressive deities such as Avanar. But, yeah. So, you can pretty much deduce that this dead man was a cleric of Aristil.
Was that an Aristil shrine that we saw back in Mucktown, or whatever the hell that town was that we docked with?
Turtleback Ferry?
Yeah.
Ever mentioning a shrine, but I would have to say no. Or there was a church there, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Yeah, it would have been.
Alright. Is it... Can I make the safe assumption that this was the cleric of that particular...
Possibly.
Can I loot it?
It is made of gold.
No, it's going back to the shrine.
I mean the body.
There's nothing on him. He's naked and holding his own organs in a bowl.
Unless you want the organs.
So it goes into my, like, the quest inventory.
Yes. Return this.
Bloody amulet. And it's despite the fact that it's made of gold, it has no value.
Yep. That's how it looks.
special about this guy? If he was, like, a cleric or... Well, not a cleric, but, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not a dick. Well, I mean, he was a dick.
But... An important dick.
Yeah.
Is what information I'm searching for.
Yeah.
Aside from the fact that for an ogre, he is... Everything about his features, with the exception of his face, is perfectly symmetrical and free of warts and gristle. So he's a very rare type of ogre that looks relatively human, which other ogres wouldn't take kindly to.
Okay, so that would be, like, frowned upon.
Yeah. Other than that, there's nothing about him other than the attempts at art in the room to say who or what he was.
Okay.
And still, there's no sound of any reinforcements on their way. And you already know that the stairway to the north goes down, and the stairway right beside you leads up.
There are other doors, though?
There are plenty of other doors going along this southern route. Looking at Menides, there's the pair of double doors there, a door there, a door there.
I'm not sure if everyone can see.
Another door down there. And Theodora's scent is just filled with nothing but
blood and gore.
Yeah, so she wouldn't be able to make out if there's anything alive or not.
You said this was a set of double doors down here?
Yes.
Alright. I should probably check that one out next. Perception check on traps.
Into a pantry where all that remains is a half-smashed crate and an untouched barrel.
Krunk goes to the untouched barrel.
Well, when Theodora and Krunk open it, there is a container of pickled fish.
Theodora takes it.
Theodora now has pickled fish.
A whole barrel.
Yeah.
A cat-sized pseudo-dragon carrying a barrel of fish.
You're debating the logic, man.
There's also another door there.
Like in Morrowind, how is it possible for me to carry, like, two full sets of armor on my back?
Right.
Because fuck you, that's why.
Krunk's eating fish. Menides opens the other door.
So Theodora and Krunk are sharing some pickled fish.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, they are. Because they're literally sharing pickled fish.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. That's actually the pantry where you're all sitting in right now is a kitchen. But yeah, everything in the pantry and the kitchen. kitchen is all smashed up and either eaten or thrown about. There's nothing of value other than the pickled fish.
And Des looks at Kronk and Theodora, and his island stones start dancing quizzically around his head.
He's making it like a question mark.
Yes. Sure, why not?
Theodora, hands towards him a pickled fish. Want some?
Menendez takes it, looks at it, takes a bite of it, sets it on the table.
Yeah, make a fortitude save not to puke.
It's pickled.
He makes a face.
Suit yourself. More for me.
Perhaps we should go up.
So, this one down here?
Up this north, right?
Oh, I thought we were... Okay.
The staircase here is the stairs that lead up. The staircase up here at the top will go down.
Okay, so this one, where Menendez is up?
Yes.
Okay.
So you all wish to go up the stairs?
Yes.
And hallways.
Yeah, there's like lots of.
Menendez goes up, followed by Kronk.
I'm gonna move Theodora back up so I can group everyone together.
I guess we're doing this.
I need to. Alright, so everybody's going to go back to the right side. Like you were during the ramparts.
I'm so confused.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, man.
Because when I heard myself coming out of the computer.
Yes.
Magic.
Yes, you most certainly heard yourself coming out of the computer.
Does that mean I'm a ghost in the machine?
Yes.
So I'm a sexy Japanese lady with purple hair.
Who is hinted upon at having been a guy once before, yes. That's the one thing to never truly answer.
It's all coming together.
Because they hinted so much that before becoming cybernetic, she was actually a dude. Alright, so... You're now on the topmost floor where you got a pair of double doors down here and another pair of double doors within Menendez's light sight down here as well. You all can make perception checks if you want.
Perception check on the door next to Menendez to spot for traps. That's a nat 20.
There's no traps, but you can hear that somebody is inside, pacing about and grumbling. Damn cats downstairs getting in the fight skin. Go down there, beat their rotten heads in there. Can never have a peaceful day, just a douche.
I let him know.
Sounds like someone important.
And then Dennis also sees another door down at the south. So, doors next to Krunk, doors there, and a single door at the south.
And it does peeks around the corner here.
Peeking around the corner shows that there's another door at the very end of the hallway.
Okay.
Still hear him pacing back and forth and grumbling.
Alright. Stan, let's make a perception check at this door to the south. This double door.
Yeah, talking inside. Something about when they're done bleeding dry, we eat them, right? Yeah, as soon as they done filling up those buckets.
Captain Menendez is checking the south door, 26.
Sounds like there might be people to save.
26. Menendez hears what sounds like a more lighter tone ogre voice speaking in the ogre language, and also hears another one just pacing back and forth.
Okay, so there's one in this room, two in this room potentially with live people, and two in this room.
Yes.
All right. So, Kronk, there may be people alive in there. So, Kronk rages and kicks in the door.
All right.
Are we going for a surprise round, or?
We're going for Kronk is raging and doesn't care.
Ah. He's here to chew bubblegum.
Kick ass.
And kick ass.
And all out of bubblegum.
Yeah.
Alright, so here's what Kronk sees in the said room.
Tribunal, I love that expansion.
Smashed chairs and ruined tables sit in this once regal chamber. Along the curved east wall hang tattered remains of several regional maps. The two ogres have three Black Arrow Ranger corpses hanging from the rafters upside down, bleeding from their jugulars into buckets underneath. When Kronk kicks in the door, they look over and kick the buckets aside like, "Oh, we got even more to bleed! Yes, let's bleed them all!"
So nobody's alive.
Yep.
Now, is this all made of wood?
The rafters and the floor beneath.
The whole interior, yes.
But
it would appear so.
Just because it's made of wood doesn't mean it burns. That's made of wood. It would take a lot for it to catch on fire.
So,
like a giant fireball?
Well, a giant fireball is like an instant flash of heat. It wouldn't necessarily be enough to really ignite it. I mean, if it were like paper,
sure.
Then yeah.
So, since Kronk kicked in the door, everybody roll initiative.
Stanton gets that.
So.
Guys. Leary gets 21.
My guys are just regular ogres.
Is it okay if I put my feet up?
Absolutely not. No.
It is never okay to put your feet up in somebody else's house. How dare you?
Jesus titty fucking Christ.
So, my guys, ouch. Menendez and Kronk.
Menendez, the 27th, 28th, Kronk, 23.
Stanton and Leary.
Stanton got a manly 4. Leary got a mere 21.
And Lucy.
2.
Wow. That makes it Menendez and then Kronk.
Is Theodora there on the initiative counter?
Well, because Theodora runs with Lucy.
Oh, I forgot about that. I'm losing my mind.
Menendez holds his action.
Alright. Then Kronk.
5 foot steps. He's holding his hook, so... Oh, wait. He doesn't get a bonus for that. Kronk...
Step, no attack, no.
Keeps rolling off. Dead going. Okay, there we go. 20.
I think you were just rolling and
until you got the dice.
20.
Like, oh, no, no, it landed on the ledge.
20 hits.
Landed on its edge 16 times.
Had to take more than 5 feet, did he?
He did.
Okay, so he gets swiped out.
Yeah, so he'd get swiped out when he was...
This one's carrying a great club.
Okay.
And he only rolled 9, so he won't hit you.
It's not just a good club.
It's a great club.
They have an open bar.
Yeah. So...
Oh, yeah.
Crit. So, crit is 2d6. Does 31 damage to it.
31 damage, yeah?
Yep.
That one is actually going to drop to the ground and start bleeding out. Battle music for Final Fantasy 13.
Yep.
Great soundtrack, great characters, just cannot get into the gameplay. That's why I can never finish it. So, one is now down on the ground, bleeding out.
How much? And that's when Menendez attacked?
Yes.
Yeah, for 31 damage.
And Krunk did like 26?
23.
Yeah, it's not going to take much to get the other one on the ground.
Drop it, drop it, drop it,
Larry.
Drop it.
Leary's not going to waste a Scorching Ray. That's just... That'd just be silly.
So, set Menendez to, like, 22... Oh, I can do it. Oh, that didn't adjust.
To... What are you trying to do?
Moving where he was in initiative order. So behind Kronk.
Okay. Oh, so you already typed it in 22.
Yeah, just to... I thought that would move it automatically, but it did not.
Let me do descending order again. There.
There we go.
Alright. I know it can't possibly kill it, but she's going to use Ray of Frost on the one in front of Krunk.
So, she has to beat an 8 on touch AC.
Alright. First off... Spell does not fail. And... How much on a touch AC?
8.
Yeah, she beats it.
Okay.
1d3. 1 to 2 is 1. 3 to 4 is 2. 5 to 6 is 3. 3.
Almost. It's turn. It's like, you killed my brother! And he's going to attack Krunk. Since Krunk is standing right there and chopped him very good. Ah, Krunk gets critted. For 2d8 plus 7, that's like a 16 plus 7 is 23.
Okay.
Times 2. 3 times 2 is 46. 46 points of damage done to Krunk.
Nice.
That's a healthy chunk of change.
It is.
Yeah. Stanton. Let's not forget the cleric also has channel positive energies.
You know what? I don't need to take this crap from you.
So it's 46.
Let's see. Using a wand of cure light wounds, that doesn't provoke an attack of opportunity. Does it?
Using a wand? I don't
Does she have it in her hand?
Stanton has it.
Stanton's the one who's up.
If he doesn't have it in his hand drawing, it would provoke.
Right.
But is he near anyone?
They have reach.
Okay, so retcon, he draws it before moving.
Okay.
Would that be a 5-foot step?
Yes.
Alright, and then... Boop! He struts...
Drawing it with the,
standard action.
Drawing is always a move, because that's why a quick draw is always nice.
I always have quick draw, so I don't remember.
So drawing is a move action, so...
So I could draw a 5-foot step and then just stick it in one of his wounds.
You can't 5-foot.
I can't 5-foot?
Nope.
Where Stanton is where the other door opens. So you would be able to... You're right there in the door frame. You can touch it.
So I don't need to move at all. I could just... Boop!
Actually, drawing wouldn't provoke.
Really?
So roll a d8.
Alright. It's just a 1... D8 plus 1. So
maybe I'm wrong.
I only take quick draw when I'm playing a character that uses throwing weapons. Because otherwise, you're going to have your weapon out.
Not always.
I like the idea of having a free action to draw a weapon in case.
A whopping 2 hit points healed.
Ha ha! Awesome!
Take that!
Lucy and Theo.
So, Kronk needs the heals?
Yes.
Okay.
Kronk
we also
heals.
Have an ogre that needs the dying.
Well, that's what she's got Theodora for.
Yeah.
Ray of Frost, that was easily the most effective spell.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, that's a game changer.
Cure Light Wounds, 1d8 plus 5. I can reach through the doorway and touch him, right?
Yeah, from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's a d8. Snap.
I will allow it.
That's not a d8. Wait.
A d8 plus your level.
You not will, I will. Okay, because you said I will.
You're hilarious.
Plus what level are we?
I'm a 7.
8?
Or
8,
yeah.
So, 7 plus 8.
15.
15.
Does Theodora do?
Theodora runs in. I guess since there are no other ogres coming up on our butts.
Yep.
Not currently.
Yeah,
despite the sound of fighting going on and these guys talking about bleeding more victims, no one else is coming out of their rooms.
So like how in Dragon Age, if all the enemies just gathered up together in one massive fight at the beginning of the dungeon, you would die. But because they conveniently spread themselves out throughout the entirety of the structure.
Well, that and you're dealing with ogres. It's worked out to where ogres fight each other all the time, even when they're part of a family. So when ogres hear fighting going on, they automatically assume, oh, they're just fucking with each other. No reason to go running to see what's going on.
Okay, so she bites...
Roll that 20.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
14.
Since you're using the roll, she can still use her bite damage.
Okay. Four plus four. Eight. Or wait. Did I roll for that, or...
were, you hit with a 14. Natural weapons don't use glancing blows. She just gets to roll her bite damage.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So with 8 points of damage, it gets dropped to the ground, bleeding out. Right at the end of the song day.
Nice.
Yeah, just for the listeners at home, we're kind of spreading out the Pathfinder Unchained rules for whoever in the group wants to use them.
What that means is we just got the book today and we're testing to see if it works.
Yeah.
Chapin's using the one attack roll for all attack rolls on her Theodora. And so far no one else is really using any of the other ones, unless Kronk's gonna use temporary hit points instead of losing all that hit points he just lost.
No, because if I was gonna use it, I would use like completely reroll him as the unchained version, and I don't feel like doing that, so he's sticking with core.
Okay. So yeah, those two drop and are bleeding out. Well, they consider it Unchained Barbarian and Core Barbarian. So.
Yeah.
I loot everything.
There's just a couple of great clubs and some javelins. Javelin!
Kronk.
What was Kronk going to do?
Go to the other door to the south and kick it in.
To the south.
Shouldn't we reposition ourselves if we're gonna...
He's in a rage. He doesn't give a shit. He's a honey badger.
Honey badger don't care.
Do you guys want to stick with initiative and I just roll the other two initiatives or re-roll initiative entirely?
I'm okay with initiative.
Stanton got a 4.
I mean, it's kind of still, it would be his turn now, and so it's still kind of the same order, so I would say keep the same initiative.
So I just need to roll my other two people.
So Theodore thinks about looting everything, and then
Kronk runs Kronk off and runs kicks off in the door.
Yeah, she's like, well.
And one of these days you're just kicking a door and it's full of, like, singing teapots and, like, candle holders and clocks.
Singing candle holders
be
and singing.
Be our guests.
Yeah.
But out of service, do the test.
Beauty and the Beast.
We've already got beasts, so, you know.
And Lucy is a beauty.
Oh, you're just flirting now. Mm-hmm. You hear that, Alex? When you're listening to this,
you hear that fictional character that he's flirting with?
Exactly.
Yep.
So, going by initiative order, there's no way of stopping him. Kronk just walks over to the door and kicks it in,
and that's
his turn.
All he could do. So.
Because he wasted an attack roll with his foot on a door.
Yes. So, Chester.
And since Menendez is in the other room, Kronk can't really see what's in said room, so...
Oh, great!
Kronk is just staring into a dark room. Until it is Menendez's turn.
So Menendez moves around.
Okay, so here's what they both see and what everybody else will see once they... The walls of this room are decorated with finely crafted longswords, stuffed animal heads, and a map of the Hook Mountain region. A large oak table surrounded by several chairs have been smashed to splinters, and an immense bed has similarly been ruined. An open cabinet that once contained several bottles of wine has been crushed as well, and broken bottles and the faint scent of wine lingers around its ruins. Here is where both Menendez and Kronk, Stanton and Leary, see pretty much these two. A female ogre and another ogre who had his jaw replaced with metal jowls.
Yay, metal!
So like the jaw guy from Venture Brothers.
Yes.
Awesome.
She is weaving magic like a sorcerer, and he's just looking like a pissed-off ogre who's like, "That good door may kill you now!" And for those of you who are familiar with the Looking for Groot comic, yes, that is Benny from Looking for Groot.
I can't see anything. Why can't I see anything?
Huh. Okay, so...
So far, Menendez just walked around. Is he doing anything else?
He sees her casting.
She's just looking all sorcerous-y.
Okay. He steps into the room and then steps to her, which would provoke an attack of opportunity.
Yeah, from the main guy. And he's... Not only does he have the metal jaws, but he's also wielding an ogre hook. There's a 25 hit Menendez.
Nope.
Nope? Alright. Then he's good.
Okay, and he... Then he's going to cast... Intensified shock and grasp. And does she have anything metal?
No, she does not.
Okay. Just, let's grab the big stack here. So it's...
Big stick.
Let's see. So first... Oh, that's going to be ridiculous. What's that? She's going to... So, 58 damage. She might not die.
No, not yet.
She probably has a name, so she won't die yet.
I was going to say, it would be like the, District 9 death with the fucking zap gun.
Fuck!
I still love that.
So,
I haven't seen it.
Oh my god. That's so good.
Oh, this, yeah, this reminds me. Back when the director felt fresh and new, and then he ended up making the same exact movie two more times.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know if you watch Comedy Central, but inside Amy Schumer, the last episode they made was a parody of 12 Angry Men, and it was beautiful. It was just surprising how much detail they went in to make it look almost exactly like the original.
Wow. Larry's turn.
She's gonna fuck shit up. What is something I can...
Be very angry!
She is going to use her own flaming sphere. Which, if you could hand me your court rule book.
Yes.
Oh, he's stealing your spells!
Yeah! That's okay, it's awesome.
Now Larry has to look at Lucy and be like, "See, that's how you do the flaming sphere."
This is how you play with your balls. That's right, people. We're scraping the bottom of the barrel when it comes to comedy.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, if only I knew the alphabet, this would be so much easier. It just exists.
Yep.
Alright. She is going to roll it towards this chick.
Alright. And she pretty much has to make a reflex save to take half the damage. Unless she has evasion, but she does not. So, reflex save. Does a 21 hit the reflex DC?
Yes.
So she only takes half the damage.
Alright. It deals 3d6 points of fire damage?
Yep.
Alright. I don't use this spell that often, that's why I have to read a lot about it. 7. So she takes 5 points of damage. This round.
Alright. She'll step out then, of course.
I mean, it's still gonna follow her.
Yeah.
So.
Alright. So, now it's the big ogre's turn. And seeing the chick beside him getting attacked only angers him more. So, looking at Menendez, he is going to fuck Menendez up, probably.
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 Not really.
He is going to power attack on Menendez. What is Menendez's AC? 30. 30? So if he hits with a 25, it'll still do at least minimum damage. Why no? Minimum damage. 2d8 plus 22. So, 24. 2. Yeah, so Menendez takes 24 points of damage due to a glancing blow. The ogre chick. She is going to take a 5-foot step away from the flaming sphere.
Menendez.
No!
Come on, there we go. Menendez follows her.
Does he have some type of immediate action?
Nope, not yet.
Like attack of opportunity?
How is he able to follow her?
Not yet. Step up.
Oh, step up.
Yep.
Nice.
What's that?
Anytime someone he is adjacent to takes a 5-foot step, he can follow them.
It's a feat.
Yeah. The next feat in the line is following step, which means he can move up to 15 feet instead of 5 feet. And then the final, the capstone of that line is step up and strike, which means after taking that move, he can attack.
Nice.
Very nice.
Yes.
Okay. Menendez is allowed an attack opportunity as she is going to attempt to cast a spell.
Which is why step up is so great. It's a caster killer.
Yeah.
Okay. So he does 27. Hit.
27 will hit.
Alright. We'll do damage. So that concentration check is going to be fun.
Yeah. So she has to beat the damage dealt to her. And and she missed it by 2 points. So, spell failure. At this point, she's going to start calling out. She's just pretty much going out top of the lungs. We're being invaded! We're being invaded! Help! And stand.
Let's see.
Hold action for when all the ogres come.
That's actually not a bad idea.
So you can charge up your channel negative energy.
Yeah. Can he at least move into the corner and then hold action? Or that would be a 5 foot step, so yeah. He'll wait right there.
Alright. So Stanton's done?
Yep.
Lucy and Theodora.
Jeez. Okay. Is that a double door or is it just a single door?
That's a single door right here.
Okay, so where do I move? I would have to just move over in order to have line of sight, correct?
Yep.
How much metal does that ogre have on him?
A lot with the hook and his jaws metal being jaw. Metal.
Chill metal.
Chill metal.
Pretty cool spell.
Yeah.
Get it? Because cool. Cool. Oh, please.
Metal equipment of one creature per two levels, no two of which can be more than 30 feet apart. Yeah, yeah. Duration 7 rounds. Will negates on an object.
How does an object get a will save?
I don't know. It has the following effects. Unattended non-magical metal gets no saving. Magical metal is allowed to save and throw. That's how it gets a little bit. Mm. I'm pretty sure his sword would be allowed to blow against it.
Yeah, but there's a difference between Commander Data and a fucking forklift.
An item should be in
a magical forklift?
An item is a creature.
One forklift to make a save.
An item in a creature's possession is allowed the creature saving throw. So, his jaw, he gets to make a saving throw for his metal jaws. Creature takes cold damage if the equipment is chilled, takes full damage if its armor, shield, or weapon is affected. I guess we could consider his mouth armor.
And his weapon. So.
Yeah.
Creature takes minimum damage if it's not wearing or wielding. First round of the spell, the metal becomes chilly, uncomfortable to touch, but deals no damage. Also occurs on the last round of the spell's rotating duration. During the second through next to last round is when the pain and damage comes in. So right now he's noticing that his mouth and hands are getting a little cold, like nothing happens yet. Remind me on the next round to deal for the damage.
Yep.
And also Theodora.
Yeah. Theodora flies up here. Because, yeah, she heard the screams.
Alright. Theodora gets to make an attack of opportunity as the pair of double doors in front of her is sprung wide open and she meets that guy in front of her.
Wonderful.
Who looks like this to everybody else?
21.
And it hits his flat foot. It's not over 5, so she gets her bite attack.
Her bite?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
grabs onto his arm, and he's just like, "Who are you?
Puny dog,
fucking cat.
You annoying! You not first one to say that."
So, he had to walk to the doors and bust them open, so his turn's done, and it's back to Krunk.
Would that count as a ready to action for Stanton, or would that just be a pause?
You didn't say what you were ready
to action. Ah, alright.
Krunk.
Krunk is going to... step in to attack this guy. That'll provoke.
Yep. That's going to be like a 16 plus 15. That's like 31.
Okay.
Does that hit him?
Yeah.
2d8 plus 13. So, 24 points of damage.
Okay.
In the hallway is fighting blindly, so they only heard the doors bust open and Theodore just latched on. So everybody else can't really see anything.
He continues in and takes a swing.
Gorobot?
Larger.
Yes.
Does an 18 hit.
18 does not hit.
Okay. He's done.
Menedez, the 27th.
Menedez, the 27th, will attack her. Can he use... So he's going to first attack. It's a crit. So it will do... 34 damage.
Ouch. That actually drops her to zero, so she's okay. On the ground bleeding out.
And then he turns, here's where the magus gets cheesy. he turns to the, ogre and casts, and screams, I mark you for Anubis, and casts Arcane Mark.
Alright, he already took his attack, so he can't do anything about it.
Some cord. Okay, that's up, so I'll take it. Plus. He does have metal. So, does a 23 hit?
Yes.
Okay. So he will do 16 damage. Arcane Mark all day long to get a free attack. Hooray for cantrips.
Leary knows that
somebody's behind them, but she cannot see.
Move the flaming sphere over to
the big guy.
Yeah, that.
Wait, where is the flaming sphere?
The flaming sphere is now on the upper left corner of the ogre.
Would it provide any light down the hall?
Another 30 feet.
30 feet should be enough for him to be able to see down the hall, though.
Let me do something real quick, then.
Yeah, that'd be something like 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. So it would go up to where Theodora is.
Excuse me.
Oh, wait. All players have light, see, and sight. So, only barely, unless it's moved. So now they can see up to where Theodora is. They just still can't see the big guy since he's still in the doorframe. So anyway, a reflex save. 16 match your DC.
I think a 16 needs it. Yeah.
So half damage again.
So, it takes 5 points of damage.
The ogre's turn. The ogre is very pissed that Menendez was the one who killed the female ogre, so he's going to power attack.
Does he get damage on his turn or on my turn?
Yours.
My turn, okay.
Does not get struck. She is gone. So that makes it Sam's turn.
I'm wondering why. It's weird because for some reason I can, moving Stanton around, I can almost fully illuminate the room to the south, but...
Because Menendez is in there with...
Well, Menendez and the fireball's in there with light, so...
All right.
Moving it chain moves you away from that angle of the wall. All
right. First, channel negative energy.
All right, so I need 2 plus 6. The red one is for the big boss guy, and the blue one is for the one that they're still fighting in the ring. So, big boss man got a 15, and the one in the room got a 21.
Okay. So... Boss guy failed.
Alright.
Mook guy won. And a quickened channel.
Ooh. So roll again?
Yeah.
Boss guy is definitely going to get that one because that's like 25.
Okay.
Mook guy failed that one because that's only an 8.
Alright. So. Um, may I borrow your block of D6s?
Where'd you go? Here we go.
Okay. These first two will be for the big boss man.
Alright. Which he takes full damage of one and half damage.
So, the one that he failed on, he takes 10 points of damage. The one that he succeeded on, will take, let's see, that's 10, 17. He will take 8 points. No, yeah, 8 points of damage on that one.
Alright.
Now for the Mook, the one that he succeeded on, let's see, 11, 14, 15, he will take 8 points of damage.
All right.
The one that he failed on, take 11 points of damage off.
Awesome. Next one we go down to Lucy and Thea. So, Lucy.
Flame Spear right next to Thea.
Also, now the guy is starting to realize that his jaws and his weapon are very cold to the touch, but he's refusing to let them go.
Because they're frozen to his hand? Have you ever licked a lamppost in winter?
What?
Any heat intense enough to damage the creature negates cold damage from the spell and vice versa on a point-for-point basis. And he does have that fireball sitting over. So,
really?
What did that fireball do to him last time?
What was the spell again?
Chill metal.
Didn't deal that much. I think it was like, I want to say 8 points of damage.
Yeah, and on this first round, you would only get to roll a d4 for the chill magic. So, your chill magic this round isn't going to do anything for him. The next round, rounds 3 through 5, the damage roll is 2d4.
Flaming Spear is a more effective spell than chill metal.
She got to look cool, though, using a spell she never did. And Leary stole that from her. So this round it
the
does...
The one time he decided to not set everything on fire.
Well, the other thing that really gets me is that I, instead of choosing chill metal, I could have chosen heat metal.
So next round, the damage is 2d4, so you have a chance of overriding its damage. I'm so sorry. So you set another fireball out, right?
Yeah.
And you're just putting it next to where Theodore is?
Fuck that cold shit, I'm burning it.
Yeah, well, I'm not... Oh yeah, he's right next to her. Yeah, I put it on him. I don't actually move on him. I just...
Hey, let me do this. I'm going to copy... Ace. Whoosh. Now the guy should be lit up, too. So, reflex save for half damage. That's not going to hit it, so... Roll your 3d6.
Alright, I have 2, I have 3. Gee. Thank you. Yeah.
attacks. Oh, Theodora attacks, yeah. So roll for Theo.
Come on, high roll. 18 plus 10, so 28.
That's going to be 5 and over. So she gets all 3 of her damage rolls in accordance to the new rules. Oof.
Okay. 1d4 and 2d6. So that's 9. That's 8. Ah, oh, jeez, math. 7. Okay, so 7 times 3. I don't know that either. Great.
7 times 3 is 21.
Okay, 21 damage.
21 damage. Awesome.
That's what I did. Oh.
Alright. So, his turn. He is thoroughly annoyed. He is not very happy that people are around messing up his shit. First thing he's going to do is rage. So now he's a raging.
Shit. He's a raging Cajun.
Yeah, Theodore pissed him off. Now he's like, I don't like you.
She has 80 hit points.
And a con, and a constitution score of 80 what?
80 hit points.
Because everybody's using max hit point roll, and...
Well, yeah, so am I, but I'm not that high.
What's her constitution score?
She gets a plus... She has a plus 2 on con.
She's also because she's usually been taking the extra skill point. A druid's is a D8 roll. So 8 plus... So 10 times 8, that's 80.
We're not level 10.
No. Constitution.
If we've been taking max values, it'd be 8 plus the 2 from her con.
I gotcha. Other way around.
So the question is, would that amount of damage drop her to 0 and negative 12?
Being entirely optimistic, she might live. Being realistic, you are about to kill her.
Let's find out, Chip. So the first attack, 6 plus 27 is 33.
Well, if she's been taking the hit point plus con, it'd be...
Well, she's been taking the skill point.
Oh, the skill point, yeah. So, 10, yeah. Okay, well.
So far, she's got 33.
Calculating right.
Plus another 6. Plus... Yep. Another 37. Plus another 4. That is 80 on the dot. She's on the ground, bleeding out, but not dead.
Hey, Chapin, he just killed your character while you were out of the room.
You're not dead!
Uh-huh.
I went ahead and rolled everything while you're still here, but... The guy came out of the room.
He was talking so much about how he hated you, so he wanted to kill your character.
The dude came out of the room and is now sharing a spot with Theodora since she's tiny.
Okay.
His hook has human bane on it, which Lucy is going to learn on a first basis what that means.
Uh-huh.
Hit her high enough to have... Actually, no. He took more than 5 feet, so only one attack even hits her.
Uh-huh.
That first attack.
Oh, she finds this hilarious.
I find... She won't die since only... If he had hit her with a full round action, which is what I rolled for, he would have hit 80 hit points, and she'd be on the ground bleeding out, but not dead. As long as somebody comes to her before 12 rounds pass, since you lose one hit point per round.
You can stabilize.
But... He had to move more than 5 feet because he wanted to get out of fireball, so I completely forgot about that. He didn't even do 80 points of damage to her. He would have only done... I know that the first... Yeah, screw it, whatever this last roll was.
Okay.
Which was 10 and 6. He would have only done 16 points of damage to her.
Okay.
He wanted to kill you.
Grinning ear to ear as he hits her, going, "My blade good for killing humans!
My blade good for pissing off players!"
When she gets struck, she not only feels the cut of the metal, but she feels dark energy surge right through her, jolting her.
Oh, jeez.
Like, that's the extra 2d6 of damage.
Like, negative energy?
Bane. Yeah, bane. So,
bane.
Yeah.
Negative energy.
Are you going to channel it?
It's the only attack I know.
Krunk probably would have heard Lucy yelling out.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh.
I thought I was safe. My turn was over.
No.
I heard something about an attack of opportunity.
You can take it if you
yes.
want.
Yes.
So go ahead and roll. Roll for your pull.
23. And does Lucy get an attack of opportunity, or?
Theodora would get an attack of opportunity.
she just rolled for Theodora.
Yeah.
But yet Lucy would as well.
Okay.
So 23 for Theodora. Theodora gets all... Oh, yeah, Theodora hits. It's only attack of opportunity.
So just the bite?
Yeah. And then Lucy gets her one attack hit.
Which is... Yeah.
But it's something.
It is something. 17 plus 6.
That's actually going to hit.
Awesome. Okay.
Since he's raging, his AC is only at 15.
Nice. So, 1d4. 7 plus 4.
Alright.
So, 11 total.
Krunk. Krunk may have heard Lucy screaming, but since he's raging, there's no... It's all down to what he wants to do. That's 26 damage.
Okay. He moved up. Let's see, does he have... Does he have the hits? What was the hits? Yes. He has... With his evade reach... he's going to
the big guy gets to attack him too.
No, he doesn't.
Oh.
With evade reach, the guy's reach is reduced to 5 feet against Kronk.
Okay.
So Kronk gets in on his charge and crits.
Yes.
Wow.
So what's he do on a crit?
Good.
So, do you want to use that 50 hit points or half damage, whichever's higher roll, because it might come into play here?
No, that's alright.
Okay. Krunk does 102 points of damage.
Does Kronk's weapon have anything that would ignore damage reduction?
No, it doesn't.
Alright, so only 2 points. It only he only loses 2 points from that damage count, so how much was it again?
102, so...
Just 100?
Just
100. Just 100.
That still has him standing and pretty pissed off.
Really?
Yeah.
How much HP does this guy have?
When he raged, it went up to 180. I broke her.
She's now Al Broker?
Yeah, Al Broker.
Okay, so.
Al Broker? Al yeah. Broker, okay. Wanted to see if.
That's the end of his turn, I take it?
Yes. So Minidaz.
I should have stood at home and played with myself.
Roddy Dangerfield. Great comedian.
Does he use it or not? beautiful. His shocking grasp also crits. So it does.
Careful.
Scene from Green Mile?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty much. With the skeleton showing through.
Oh, God.
Fatality.
Nice.
You just hear a dismembered voice go, Raiden wins. Fatality. So I don't know who this Raiden is, but that was awesome. Leary. Literally witness this guy take a huge chunk out of Lucy.
Fireball from the south heads up to guy in the north.
You do realize that would mean that it rolls through you guys. Fireball rolls until it hits a target.
Friendly targets count for it.
They do.
So it'd have to roll through her, Lucy, on it to... She's better off dismissing it or leaving it, but...
Yeah, god or, damn it.
Well, or putting it in the hallway in case we get attacked from that way.
Okay, if we get attacked from the other way now, we're just fucked. No, she's gonna go ahead and dismiss it. Yeah. And use... her last... still scorching ray against the big guy.
Oh no!
He has a touch AC of who?
7. Large.
Okay, she hits.
Yep.
And she hits.
Okay.
Gonna borrow your block of dice. I should really get my own block of dice, but. Whatevs. 26 points of damage.
Ouch.
Wait. That would be actually 20. Actually, that'd be 32.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's going to drop him. Let's see. Losing the extra 22 hit points because of rage immediately ending. That's going to drop him and kill him outright. So explain Leary killing him.
He's being all badass because he's got this little like rodent wrapped around his arm that's not really doing anything. Leary's been turned to fucking a pile of mush.
You mean not Lola?
Lucy.
Lucy.
Too many L's.
Yeah.
Too many L names.
Too many L names.
Lucy's been almost turned into just a pile of stew. Kronk runs up. He does this massive damage, but he's still at, like, a half health. He thinks he's on top of the world. And then spies. And just as she's about to launch it, he spies from the back of the battlefield Leary aiming a ray that fires two times through his eyes.
And melts his brain.
Yes.
Nice.
Which he immediately drops to the ground all in a heap.
After which, Kronk screams, "You heard Lucy!" and decapitates him.
Alright. So now his head rolls a bit.
Oh, and now that the battle's over.
And Theodora pees on him.
Now that the battle's over, Stanton's going to use two uses of channel positive energy. So I'm going to need 6d6.
For the heals.
Yep.
I was actually kind of worried about the fight against him since he had that human being weapon and all of you decided to be humans.
So let's see. 10.
18.
So that's 8. So yeah, you all heal for 19 points of damage.
Yes.
But it just seemed like the minute he stepped out of that door, he was ganked on. I'm sure that of all the people that listen to this, plenty of them are GMs going, "You could have easily wiped the party if you had him do this or this, instead of just standing there waiting for his attack roll."
Nice. Grunks screams and looks a little bit better. Stops raging and looks a little worse.
Crunk don't feel good.
Can Lucy do some heal? Just regular heal, non-magical. I don't know if it would actually do anything.
No, it doesn't.
Give him the good touch.
Yeah. Well, she bandages him up.
Taking care of him. No, it doesn't actually do anything.
It would have to be magic.
Well, then she's fussing over him. Fine.
So as we close up shop, here's what we know so far. You guys have killed 6 ogres in the interior of this fort. You now know that this top floor is cleared, since there's only the one other room you haven't been in, and that's the room of the chapel, which the walls within this enormous chamber are mounted with dozens of trophy antlers, some taken from stags that must have stood as tall as dire bears. Most of the antlers are draped with bits of rotten flesh, strips of skin, or coils of viscera. Whatever. To the west, a marble altar has been heaped with the mangled remains of at least half a dozen dead men and women. The crude image of what might have been a three-eyed jackal has been painted in blood on the wall above the altar's alcove. As Stanton, you recognize that this altar was once dedicated to Aristel, and you are able to recognize that it has been turned into a makeshift altar to Lamatsu by the ogres.
Gotcha.
And on the...
As an aside, Gaia and Erastel would get along very, very well.
Gaia and what?
Erastel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
And on Father Krieg was...
So she would probably be pissed off about this altar.
Gotcha. Okay.
Two potions of cure. potions of cure serious wounds. Another plus one hide armor for giants. A plus one human bane ogre hook. And a belt of giant strength plus two.
Lucy cleans the altar.
So... plus one overhook of human bane?
Yeah. Then there was the sorcerer's chip. She had one potion of cure serious wounds, a wand of acid arrow with 43 charges, also carried an amulet of natural armor plus one, a headband of alluring charisma plus two.
Theodora steals it.
And a ring of protection plus one.
And when I say that Theodora steals something, you can take it away from her. Yeah.
Well, we all know where it is.
Right.
I wanted to bet that Stanton and Lucy are already wearing charisma-based headbands, right?
I am.
I forget. There's no little figure on here.
Alright, so...
It should be.
What's your charisma score? Oh, wait, you won't even have to worry about
no,
charisma.
No, yeah. Mine was wisdom.
Yeah.
What I bumped up.
And I think everybody's... I think just about everybody is using a natural armor amulet, I think.
I don't know if Stanton is using one yet.
If not, that's another point of armor class he gets.
Alright.
Excuse me.
Ring of Protection. This ring offers continual magical protection in the form of a deflection bonus. So, I'm willing to bet that nobody here has a deflection bonus to their AC, so that Ring of Protection is up to grabs to anyone. Another 1 point to your armor class.
And it is, already has one.
Leary has one, I don't think Stan does.
Theodora steals it.
So she use it.
Well, yeah, but...
If it fit around an ogre's finger, it probably fits around her neck.
Yeah.
So either Theodora gets another point of armor class, or somebody else swipes it from her.
Stanton?
Krunk could use it.
Sam is looking at 18 in his AC with a damage reduction of 5.
Krunk has a amulet of natural armor and a belt of giant strength.
So, going once?
Krunk?
Going twice? Krunk?
Yep.
Krunk it is.
Krunk swipes it from her. And he's pretty much able to wear it like a bracelet. It is now the bracelet of protection plus one. So yeah, you all managed to fall 6 ogres in this fort. You know that this upstairs portion is clear. You don't know if there's any more on the ground floor. And there is a basement area to clear out. And you're not sure of your NPC friends, wherever they are and what fate may have befallen them, as we close shop.
Those were ominous words.
Yep.
So since we know the floor is clear, what was in that room we didn't look at that was off to the side?
That was a chapel. A chapel to Aristotle, which...
No, the,
Oh, down at the bottom?
And that, on the other floor.
That door actually would have led to the outside area between the fort and the ramparts.
Okay.
So there's nothing to that at all except walking space to nowhere.
Okay.
Questions, comments, or anything before we shut down recording? Nope.
I'm glad Lucy didn't die.
She wouldn't have died even if the whole round attack went through. She'd just be on the ground unconscious.
No, because it would have hit her at 80, so it would have put her at 0, so she would have been disabled. So yeah. She would have still been standing, but just very limited in what she could do.
I thought once you hit 0, that's when you're on the ground unconscious waiting out.
Nope. At 0, you're disabled. You can take one standard action, one standard or one move action, not both. And your movement is limited to 15 feet. If you do anything that would require more, like something that would require a lot of effort, like trying to do something that would require a full round action, you would pass out. And start bleeding out.
So it's when you hit negative that you start.
Yep.
Attacking. So dropping the negative one would start her passing out.
Okay. Well, that's a relief. Because I was hearing you guys talk in the bathroom, and all I could think was, I'm going to have to re-roll my character.
Nah, I wouldn't go that far. Lucy has divine intervention on her side, after all.
Yay!
She's got a goddess that she helped bring into being.
And lots of fate points.
Yeah, and lots of fate points.
Well, three. Three left.
Alright, pass those in if you haven't yet. And on that... And on that note, we will... end tonight's session, and we will see you all next week. So, thank you for joining us, and we will see you again soon.
Night.
Good night.
What's everyone looking at me for?
Good night.
Good night.